What's good? What's good, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of The Urban Platform Speaks. This is a Money Monday edition, and I have my co-host with me, Lisa Florenzen. And our topic for today is how to create multiple streams of income. And that's what we'll be speaking about today. So Lisa, how you been doing, first of all?
Good. How's it going over there in beautiful Maryland?
It's good. Just trying to stay busy. Just trying to stay busy.
Excellent. Did they clean up that mess over there on that bridge yet?
No, they still working on it. It's going to be a while before they can replace that bridge. So for they just rerouting traffic, but it hasn't caused any backups or anything on an alternate route. So it's going pretty good. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah. So let's talk about now. The reason I wanted to talk about like multiple streams of income, because I know that people who have full-time jobs, or maybe they have or they may be entrepreneurs and they may be looking to expand and get into different ways of, to bring in different money or more money, I should say. And so you provided me with a list, and we're going to start with the number one on the list was caregiver. And that should be like a easy one to get into, like caregiving, something extra that you can do, besides the normal job that you have. So let's talk about caregiving and how, people can get into that.
Well, yeah, absolutely, Mike. So this kind of touches a little bit on the last week's show about, mm-hmm. different things that people can do, different areas of, for people to explore. Caregivers, obviously, there are, 10,000 or 12,000 boomers per day, I believe, are turning 65 and over. And that way there are going to be more seniors on the planet, honestly, than there will be Gen Zers. So, and that is a fact. The caregiver role is not an easy one, but if you are good with people and you are already doing it, maybe taking care of a child or loved one, and you may or may not be getting any recompense or any compensation, there are programs where the state will actually help you pay you to become a caregiver to someone, or especially to your family. So there are some states that offer that opportunity. Mm-hmm. There's also caregiving. So that is something, let me go back. That's something that's not going to go away, because as people keep living longer and seniors want to live in their homes and things of that nature, I mean, you could do anything from like light cleaning and meal prep and maybe just picking them up and taking them to some appointments and things of that nature. You could start off with someone you know. Caregiving also obviously extends to children and also pets. So, you can be one of my first jobs, businesses that I started when I was like way long ago was actually pet sitting. And then that pet sitting, and it turned into house sitting. So I was house and pet sitting. And then that also turned into house cleaning. So there are certain opportunities that can evolve from just doing one thing. And even if you don't feel you're that good at it, I mean, if you're a caretaker, you've taken care of even a plant, chances are you could probably take care of someone's animal, someone's children, and, maybe a family member. So that's definitely a good area to create a side hustle in.
Okay. Yeah. And also because there's such a demand, and the schedules probably are flexible.
Seniors need seniors need somebody to be around them all night. Mm-hmm. And sometimes those are great opportunities for someone to just be there, and they call them like sleep schedules, where you can actually sleep at the place where you're taking care of that person. And then you get up and you, you know, maybe fix them a breakfast or what have you. And then maybe somebody else comes in and switches out, a family member or something of that nature.
Okay. That's cool. All right. Let's move on to the next one, and that is AI consultant. And so tell us about AI consultant.
So with AI, you know, obviously it can be used for good or bad, right? Just like we kind of talked last week, it's a good thing, it's a bad thing, and we'll go into that in our next show. But helping people navigate that is really important. There are a lot of free courses online, some of which I've taken.
Okay.
That really give you a great opportunity to get your feet wet in what is AI, how does it work, how you can make it work, and how you can make it work as an income stream for yourself, maybe helping someone else with their content. AI can help you do that easily, helping you create graphics, helping you get someone organized. These are all things that AI can help you do, and then you can help someone else do the same and get paid for it.
Okay, good. And also that AI consultant is something also, again, that's flexible, you know, and that people can, you know, work around their schedule with the AI consultant.
Absolutely. Okay. Yes.
All
as long as you have an internet connection.
Let me see. The next one we have on the list is real estate. You can definitely do real estate as a side hustle.
Yes. And here's the thing. May have touched on this before in another show, but multimillionaires usually have no less than 7 income streams. And a lot, I would say, in my best guess, 90% of them, if not 95%, have some type of real estate portfolio. They're doing something in real estate, whether it's a fixing and flipping or buy and hold or creating apartment complexes or senior assisted care facilities, whether it's even buying your first car wash or whether it's buying a laundromat. Those all pertain to real estate. And there are various ways for someone to create a side hustle with little to no money. I know that sounds crazy for some people, but it's been happening for years. It'll happen way after I'm gone, and it's happening today.
So that's good. Yeah, and I think a lot of people are attracted to real estate because of real estate is so, like you said, it's so many different ways to get into real estate. And you know, you really don't need a ton of money depending on what, you know, what avenue you're going to take far as, you know, getting into real estate. So yeah, that's a real good option for people too. Okay. So, and let's go to the next one is, this one was good, thrifting. And people may not know that there are opportunities into, thrifting and flipping items, but this is a real good one.
Yes, actually, just to be really transparent, you know, I was shopping in thrift stores before it was cool to shop in thrift stores. Okay, so that's been like decades of stuff. Yeah. You know, as the eldest daughter of a single mom, that was basically how I got a lot of my clothes. So, and I still, honestly, I got no shame. I still shop at thrift stores today. Now, there's twofold. I shop in them because, obviously, you know, I prefer to shop in thrift stores, honestly, because I find amazing deals with tags still on them in thrift stores. And that's not to say that I don't buy new things. It's just that I, you know, it's in my blood. The second thing that I've noticed about is that there's an entire industry, you know, I mean, take a look at the secondhand stores anyway. They have made an entire industry out of flipping items. So that industry has carried over to the individual where you can, you know, you can start a Mercari account or you can flip things on Facebook Marketplace or eBay or Twice or ThredUp. I mean, these are all online, Poshmark. These are all online retailers that will pay you for your items that you can list on those channels, or just do it yourself. You know, create a simple page, put your stuff on there, and believe it or not, thrifting is set to outpace people buying new stuff, like, period. Thrifting is a great way to take a $2 or $3 item and turn around and flip it for profit, you know. And a tip that I have learned recently is that unless I have a big dollar item that I know I'm going to make a good margin on, I always make the buyer pay shipping. Because I have eaten a lot of products because I did not factor in shipping and basically lost money. You know, maybe I only, you know, lost a few bucks, but still everything adds up. So do your research, but there are so many easy ways for people to get started. And guess what? All it takes is your phone. You can shoot and post from your phone. So you don't even need any tech skills to get started. And you can flip almost anything from phones to home items to clothing to baby items. You can flip it all.
Yeah, that's a really good one. That's a really good one. They even have a show. What is that show? Have you ever seen a show where these people like bid on stuff that's in a garage? What is
Oh my gosh, I can't even think about it now, Mike. But that I used to watch that show all the time. Go in and they buy the lockers, the storage lockers. Storage Wars.
Yeah.
That's what it's
storage
called.
Storage Wars. Yeah.
I watched that show for years.
Yeah. I didn't know that stuff existed either until I watched Storage Wars.
It's great. Yeah. Again, another opportunity to fix, you know, to take items and flip items if you buy a storage locker.
Yeah, that's a good, because they take those items and put them in their own store and mark them up and sell them. That's a nice.
And guess what? I hate to tell you, but even though I shop at thrift stores, I'm very cautious now about what I buy in a thrift store, because unfortunately, those items are getting maxed out. Like, I could go buy some of those items brand new elsewhere, and I won't even go into that right now. I won't even go into that.
I had some people tell me that too, like, for the same price that you could get them at like Salvation Army or one of these other, sometimes they'll be, you're better off buying them new depending on what they are charging at the thrift store.
Absolutely. Sad to say, but it's true.
Okay. All right. So, and the next one, our last one is investing in startups. Now let's talk about investing in startups.
Now, you know, back in the day, you could maybe get on your, you know, Ameritrade account or your Charles Schwab account or whatever, hop on and maybe get an inside and maybe buy some stock if you knew that it was about to go public, in the sense that, you know, if it was already public, then you can buy it at that, you know, open price. There are places to buy pre-IPO. What I meant to say is, back in the day, buying that before it opened was only privileged to the people that were either working in the company or founders or, you know, board members or things of that nature. But the cool thing is that with portals like Start Engine and WeFunder, you know, the Bad Shark, what is his name? Mr. Wonderful.
I know who you're talking about.
Kevin O'Leary.
I forgot it. Okay, right.
Yeah. So Mr. Wonderful actually invests and is part of the dynamic of Start Engine. And how Start Engine works is basically it's a crowdfunding site, but it allows you to invest in brand new companies that do have some traction. So they do have some sales. They may have some, you know, celebrities that have founded them or what have you, or people who have exited out of other startups and then started these and decided that they were going to go to Start Engine or WeFunder and have the average Joe and Jane, like you and I, invest in their companies for as little as $100. That means you actually own shares in a company for as little as $100. And these are pre-IPO, meaning pre-initial public offering shares that you can hold on to. And hopefully that company, you know, launches into, you know, the NASDAQ or what have you, and they trade on the public, you know, stock exchange, and you make your return. The cool thing about being able to invest in a startup is that you get to see the founders, you get to see where they're headed, how much sales they've had. So you, as someone who may not have any stock experience, you at least get to read on what they're doing, how they're changing the market in their industry. And again, the average Joe and the average Jane can get into those new companies for as little as $100. And that is literally the cost of maybe a decent meal for two out.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, with the potential of making a profit, you know, you can't beat that, you know. You can't beat that. So yeah. All of these, you know, all of these ideas and, you know, that you gave were great. And, I think, you know, people look into these, I think, you know, that they'll have, you know, ways to make money or extra money depending on what their interests are. I just want to add that, like, no matter what side hustle or extra career that people try to go into, it's going to take some hard work, and it's going to take a level of tenacity and determination, just like your guy here, famous Amos. You know, so tell me about, like, what you admire about, you know, famous Wally Amos.
I gotta say, first of all, I'm a fan of chocolate chip cookies, and I was always a fan of his. And even though he is my top entrepreneur of my top three entrepreneurs, I admire this guy so much, because I think Wally's now in his 80s. And he's still out there reinventing himself. He was born in 1936. You know, he came from humble beginnings, you know, literally a poor child in a poor, impoverished environment. And, you know, I can relate to that. And in the sense that, you know, the really cool thing I discovered about Wally a long time ago is that he was actually really integral in discovering some recording artists that we know and have come to love to this day. And that he was the first Black talent scout at William Morris Agency. And the William Morris Agency is a very famous Los Angeles-based, you know, talent agency for some of, you know, the world's biggest celebrities, sports people, and so on and so forth. And he was the first one to hop on board there and discover Simon and Garfunkel. When he discovered them, he was basically, the gates were open and he brought on Diana Ross, he brought on Sam Cooke, and he brought on Marvin Gaye through his department. Wow. And I love that about him, because I love things, entertainment and music as well. And he was he was the point guy for the William Morris Agency. And then on top of that, you know, he also took his grandmother's recipes and love for hometown, you know, home style cooking. And she would make these amazing cookies. And that's the recipe that he used to start the Wally Amos, famous Amos cookie company. Now, he was bought out by Keebler in the 90s. So he did exit out of there, but he had some failures in between. And I love the guy because he's just tenacious. You know, he's resilient. And I have a deep admiration for him and his products and his story. And he had a really great quote that said he had just lost a company, one of a few of many failures he claims to have. And he said, "I lost a company So what? It's just stuff. You can't take it with you. And I love that because that's kind of my philosophy. You're here now. You got 24 hours. You can't take it with you. So go big or go home.
Right, right, right. Yeah, I mean, I appreciate that. You know, I definitely heard of Famous Amos, and I like the cookies too, but I didn't know anything about like Simon and Garfunkel and his relationship, you know, his connection to Diana Ross and Marvin Gaye. You know, I had no idea about that. I appreciate you, you know. That's pretty cool. Good stuff.
Yeah. He was a Maverick for sure. Yeah. I mean, you know, way before Mr. Jerry Maguire, Show Me the Money.
He was
the Jerry Maguire for William Morris back in the day.
Wow, yeah, that's cool. And like you said, so the characteristics that he had, those are the kind of characteristics no matter what, you know, we strive to do that we are going to have to put into effect if we want to be, you know, successful at anything. So that was a great example, you know, and I appreciate you.
Oh, absolutely. Then, like you said, Mike, you know, you can't be an entrepreneur if you're not willing to be tenacious, if you're not willing to be resilient, if roadblocks and obstacles are not your thing, then don't be an entrepreneur.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. That's the truth. That's definitely the truth. So, again, I appreciate that. Okay, so with that being said, make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. Also, let me see what else. Also, you know, you can if you like, you more than welcome to contribute to the support the channel, help us grow. Go to our website, urbanplatformfashion.com, and check out our merch. We have hoodies, T-shirts, long sleeve and short sleeves. And so I appreciate that. Anything else, Lisa, you want to add before we end this video?
I think I just want to say that, you know, this is such a great channel for people. I know there's millions of other channels and YouTube channels out there that people could be watching. And the fact that your little, you know, channel is growing is awesome. You know, I hope that we are providing good information for your people out there. And, you know, we are here to help in any way. I mean, you know, ask us questions, you know, put them in the comments, you know, if they're specifically for Mike or myself, please, you know, we're here to listen and try to give feedback. And of course, that merch is on fire. So you want to have an Urban Platform Fashions hoodie in your arsenal of hoodies. So get one.
Absolutely. Yeah, I appreciate that. I appreciate that. With that being said, we appreciate you all. And make sure to like and subscribe, leave a comment, and we will check you all out on the next program.